Does success equal fulfillment?
When I was a kid, I thought success was being able to drive. And when I was finally able to drive, I got my first vehicle. It wasn't mine, it was my parents', and it was a 12-passenger green, ugly van. It had this huge eagle on the back of it, and then the bumper sticker that said, "Fight smog, ride a horse." Wasn't cool at all. I still thought it was gonna be great though. I could drive and I could do all these things, but really, in reality, what it ended up being was I was a chauffeur. I had to take my sisters and my brothers to practice, and I had to pick them up from school. And I guess it just really wasn't what I thought it would be. And same thing, I go to college and then I graduate and I get a job and you think, okay, this is success. This is, you know, I'm gonna be living the life, making the money, putting money away. And then you get there and you're like, well, I don't know if this is really what I was looking for either. So does success equal fulfillment?
What is fulfillment then? Why do some people feel fulfilled with what they do and the jobs they have and others don't feel fulfilled? I think a big part of feeling fulfilled is being able to contribute. And not just contributing stuff, but being able to contribute your talents. It's like your gifts, your abilities, what you're good at.
Sometimes I feel like people think that what they get out of it is what's gonna make them happy. So they feel like success is being able to get something for themselves and then they'll feel satisfied. When I think back to my first job, it wasn't when I got my paycheck that I felt satisfied with what I was doing. It was when I was able to help somebody walk again. It's like the act of contributing or sharing my talents with other people.
And it's not just what you are doing that will make you feel satisfied. Like, you don't just have to treat patients and then you'll feel satisfied, but you can do any other thing. Like, accountants can be happy, or janitors, or school bus drivers, all the other jobs out there. They can feel fulfilled by using their own abilities and their own gifts and talents for other people. That's what will bring true satisfaction and fulfillment.
Antonio is a really good dancer. Ever since he was little, he was always dancing around and doing all kinds of stuff, and you could show him any move. He could watch a move on a show or something and he could pick it up really quickly. Dancing is his what, though. That's the way he shows his talent. I feel like what his talents are is he catches on quickly, he's coordinated, and he works hard at something. He's ambitious, and he does it till he's successful.
Just like with making video, I am not a talented filmmaker. Like, that's not my gift. My gift is being creative and being ambitious and learning things quickly and catching on quick. That's what I'm talented at. And when I use those abilities to make videos, to be able to share with you guys, that's when I feel the most satisfied. Megan is talented and gifted at desiring to learn. Like, she has a great memory and can recall anything from seriously like third grade. Like, she can recall stuff that I'd be like, what in the world? How do you still remember that? And this has helped her throughout her career. Like, she's been able to use her talents in that to make a great clinician. When she treats patients, she can recall information to be able to use in her treatment session.
I really do enjoy learning, but what makes me feel most satisfied is when I get to contribute to other people. So I can do that in my job in physical therapy, but even just in my regular everyday life, when I share something that I know and it's helpful to somebody else and they find value in it, that's when I feel most satisfied.
And it's also okay if you don't know what your talents are or your gifts are. You can learn about them. Sometimes doing like personality tests or figuring out what your strengths and weaknesses are can help you figure out what you're talented at. And when you can determine that, I feel like it'll set you up for success in whatever you do.
What if you're scared to use your gifts? I remember when I was in school, I had a professor that actually pulled me aside and they said, like, why don't you ever share anything in class? Like, you have a lot of great stories and you have a lot of great information that you could contribute and you don't ever say anything. And I remember thinking, like, I don't know, I just like keeping to myself. I was quiet, you know? And if somebody had a question, they could always come ask me. And I just think back on that experience and think, instead of looking at that point and thinking, oh, success is when I graduate, like thinking of it as an experience. And if I would have contributed and shared my gift throughout my whole life, not just like at points where I thought it was necessary, how different that would have looked.
Another way to be fulfilled is by being thankful, like having an attitude of gratitude. Yeah, anyways, like being thankful for your house, your home, your kids, your dogs, your cats. Are you a dog person or are you a cat person? And not only just being thankful, but show appreciation. So if I gave my wife a gift, for example, and she never used it, I'd be like, what the heck, you know? Like, did you even like the gift? But if I gave her a gift instead and she used it every day, I'd be like, man, she really appreciates the gift and she's thankful for it. And that's the same thing with our talents and our gifts. If we use them for other people, if we contribute them to society, then I feel like we will feel the most fulfilled through that. Thanks for watching the video, guys. We appreciate you guys taking the time to watch them, to like them, to comment on them. We truly appreciate it. And if you're new, consider subscribing if you want to keep up with what we're doing. We usually post one video every week on Saturday, so stay tuned till the next one. Peace.